Over 300 teams start the season with hopes of making it to the NCAA tournament, but only 64 lucky teams received an invitation. These teams start their journey down the road to the Final Four in today's game between the St. Bonaventure Bonnies and the LSU Tigers. This is where both teams wanted to be, Dick. Let's not wait any longer to get this one started. Points of emphasis, Dick. What do you got for us?
First of all, encourage all players to be somewhat aggressive at the offensive end. Spread out the attack. Next, they can't be afraid to juggle their lineup, especially when players aren't fatigued. Make subs if that's the case. Lastly, rebound, rebound, and rebound, specifically at the defensive end. Limiting the opponent to one shot is always a goal.
We're set for the tip-off.
As we tip into the first half, the butterflies are flying, baby.
Here comes a pick.
Hey, ball screens are such an important part of the game these days. Guys are so creative when it comes to using that ball screen.
Dickey's still applying great pressure on the dribbler. Good defensive stance there against the spin move.
Well, the key is to beat him to the spot, and he did a great job. He anticipated that spin move.
The ball goes out of play. Now let's take a look here at the tempos for both these teams tonight.
Well, it looks like both of them are going to be battling to see who can control the tempo and put pressure on the opponent.
Controlling the ball. They'll work it around the arc. He's all alone. They got it. The small forward gets the pass. Now they work it around the perimeter. Tries for two. The lay-in.
Defense breaks down again. Nobody rotates over from the help side.
Up and inside.
Goes up for two.
Up and in.
Watch your head, young fella.
There's a bad pass right to the defender.
Number five takes the pass. Blocks the shot. The Tigers have got to continue to get him the ball.
They need to keep feeding him the ball. It's simple.
I tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on a box. Turnover City, that will always really negate any offense.
There may be a pick and roll here, Dick.
You've got to love the pick and roll, especially when it's run to perfection, Brad.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Pull-up jumper, left side.
Missed the jumper. The perimeter. For two,
the lay-in.
The Tigers prefer a more balanced attack. They play up-tempo at times and then really settling in the half court at other times.
You know, balanced teams will definitely give you a combination of the two styles. Some teams will play up-tempo on offense and be half-court oriented at the defense.
He makes the block. He misses the fadeaway.
Up and in.
Replay of the night, baby.
Coach making a call from the sidelines. Number five handles the pass. Adam Momentary look from three-point land. Great block there from the post, Dick.
Wow, Brad, that was superb defensive positioning, allowing him to make the block.
This one will come in from the baseline. 9 on the shot clock.
Great shot block right there. Yeah, some good movement on the offensive side.
The power forward with the ball.
Nice hops.
Working it around the perimeter. The skip pass is picked off.
Wow, what hops, baby, what hops. There it is, Jam City.
We'll be able to use their tempo and come out with a win here, Dick.
Well, it all comes down to execution. If you can put points on the board playing your style, your opponent will have to make adjustments that may affect their tempo and what they will do well.
The point guard with the ball. And our trifecta for the night. Aaron Andrews on the sideline. I'm Dick Vitale. I'm Brad Nessler. Nice to have you along with us.
Let's see the replay on that one. Coming inside.
Seconds to shoot. Blocks it. Both teams are looking to get something going here. They work the perimeter. He shoots from the top of the circle. Sticks the deuce. On the dribble, gives it up. Pass out of the post, turnaround jumper.
Nothing but nylon, nice smooth turnaround jumper. The only negative, he's falling away. If he misses, he's got no rebounding ability.
Goes up for two. Put up, blocks the shot, kicks it out. For three, 10 on the shot clock. Whoa, not a good decision to take that shot.
Hey, Brad, their shot selection has been questionable. Too many outside jumpers. They've got to attack inside and then out.
Seems as though fatigue is set in for some of these guys. Cross court. For two. And in and out. Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper. Tries for two. Perfectly executed. Gave it up. man on the shot clock. Kicks it out. Hurries it to beat the clock.
Not this time.
The small forward gets the pass. Seconds to get it off. And he goes with a spin.
I tell you, feel the defensive player on your hip going one way, the spin back the other way.
Looking for a good shot. On the shot clock. Number three handles the feed.
The lay-in.
Looking for a good shot. Stolen away. Pushing in transition. This school is known for football. It's great to see that the basketball program is now getting some of that attention.
Hey, their football program has been successful over the years, but Hoops is making a name for itself.
Takes the pass in the paint. They work it around the perimeter. 10 on the shot clock. Goes up with it. Number one is whistled for the defensive foul. Number 33 gets in on his first minutes tonight.
Hey, this kid really knows how to keep the offense moving. Tremendous leader out there.
All right, let's check in third member of our team again. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad and Dick, how about this crowd? They're enjoying this close matchup, and there's nothing better than a close game during tournament time.
EA, of course, our third member, getting that additional insight and dealings from the sideline. Number 32 makes his first substitution.
I'll tell you what I like about him, Brad. He brings all kinds of energy to the floor. Great pass out of the trap, Ryan.
Boy, terrible execution on offense. Both teams looking to get things going here. On the outside. Number 15 is called for the foul. That one puts the personal in personal. Picks up the foul.
I tell you, poor play defensively. Look at the facial expression.
They've got him trapped here, Dick.
He's trapped, Brad. And we're trapped really well there, Brad.
The shooting guard takes the feed. He takes the open jumper. That's an ill-advised shot. I don't think that's the guy you want shooting from the three-point line.
Yeah, I'm not sure what he was thinking there.
The ball goes out of bounds. They'll throw it in from the side. Inside. That spin move's not going to work against this defense.
That's a no-no, baby. Defensive player beats him to the spot.
The power forward gets the pass. Turnaround jumper. He takes the board. Number two takes the feed. On the outside. He pump fakes. 10 on the shot clock. They really seem to be letting this one get away, Dick.
Yeah, there's been a breakdown somewhere. They need to talk this one over, Brian.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. Ten seconds on the clock. Up and in. Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. They're 15 to 17 feet apart.
Ten seconds on the clock. They go with the entry pass on the post. Turnaround jumper.
I tell you, what a nice turnaround jump shot. Soft as velvet, fading away, impossible to block.
Way out on top, controlling the ball. On the dribble, gives it up. Seconds to put up a shot. Launches the three. Great shot. They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, they're really doing a great job packing it in, then a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
Ten on the shot clock. Gave it up. He shoots from the top of the circle. He buried that one from way deep. Number 20 gets the pass.
Look at that spacing.
He goes with a spin.
I tell you, feel the defensive player on your hip going one way and the spin back the other way.
Turnaround jumper.
Nothing but nylon. Nice, smooth turnaround jumper. The only negative, he's falling away. If he misses, he's got no rebound in the building.
They're working around the perimeter. Now the turnaround jumper. He grabs the rebound. Takes the pass in the paint. Goes up for two. Number one walking back out onto the floor.
He needs to get himself warm playing defense first before he starts to think about offense.
I like it when the team gets to the free throw line. It shows that they're being aggressive. The key is to get to the line early in the game and often.
Number three subs back out of the court.
You'll see the D quickly readjust, Brad.
Trap could spell some trouble. Escapes the trouble and makes a pass out. Dick, he's in a serious rhythm.
Hey, that's because he's getting the ball in rhythm, Brad. Very important.
Moving it around the perimeter.
He almost found himself in some trouble there, Brad.
They'll work it around the arc. Good defensive stance there against the spin move.
Well, the key is to beat him to the spot, and he did a great job. He anticipated that spin move.
Now they work it around the perimeter. Ten seconds showing on the shot clock. There's the tempo for the game thus far.
Long possessions, a few fast breaks is the reason for that, Brad. Up and inside.
Turns it over.
Now on the run. For the bucket.
The layup.
I'll tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking out of box.
For two.
Up and in.
Number 32 handles the feed.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
With a jump hook. He takes the rebound. There's such a variety of team styles these days, Dick. What are some of the qualities for a half-court team?
Hey, they play slower in transition and wouldn't look to attack as much as some up-tempo teams. Typically, they are very patient when it comes to half-court offense.
The point guard gets the ball. Escapes the trouble and makes a pass out. Kicks it out. Ten on the shot clock. The center with the ball. Tries for two. Number three is charged with the foul. Number 50 subs back in.
Hey, that little breather, they just have been what the doctor ordered. Is that how they say it, that saying, Brad?
Opportunity now for an easy one. Sinks it. Number 14 re-enters the ballgame.
Quick blow and he's ready to go. Trying to go inside.
The Bonnies really rely on a half-court attack at the offensive end. Eh?
They sure do, Brad. They like to work the clock and wait until the defense breaks down.
Oh, the cheerleaders into it big time for their team.
They are really involved. I'll tell you one thing, they bring a lot of spirit.
Going to move it around the perimeter. Turnaround jumper.
Nothing but nylon. Nice, smooth turnaround jumper. The only negative, he's falling away. If he misses, he's got no rebound in the building.
And a momentary look from three-point land.
And a slam.
There's what the game tempo is looking like tonight.
A little half-court action and a little fast breaking, Brad. As a result, we have a balanced tempo reading.
Two-for-one opportunity. With the catch. Nice execution on the spin.
I tell you, great spin move to the basket.
Working it around the perimeter. Goes up for two.
The layup.
Shot clock is dead. On the dribble, gives it up. He shoots the jumper. He hits a bullseye again.
Hey, he's feeling it from everywhere, baby.
At halftime, the Tigers are up by 12. It's been a tight battle so far, Dick. Do you have a highlight of the half in your book?
I love this dunk right here, Brad.
Highlight of the half for me. I'd love to see more of this in the second half.
It's time to get back to the court, Nick, and see how the second half plays out. LSU did a heck of a job shooting that ball in the first half.
I mean, no doubt about it. These boys are given too much time to shoot, if you ask me. They basically have time to wait and get a good shot. The defense was non-existent, Mr. Nessler.
Number three subs back into the thick of things, Dick.
Hey, you can't keep a guy like this out for too long, Brad. He's just too valuable.
Let's check in courtside with Aaron Andrews. Aaron?
Well, Brad and Dick, as you can imagine, both coaches were very intense as I met with them at halftime. They said at this point, it all comes down to playing their game, having fun, and enjoying the moment. Guys?
All right, thanks, Aaron.
Up and inside. The defender's doing a great job of applying ball pressure.
The point guard receives the ball. Look at these fans. They're loving it.
They just have to focus, Brad. That's most important. Mental toughness.
And there's a look at the backcourt comparison, Dick.
Okay, Brad, you always want to know how the primary ball handlers are doing. Are they getting their team's quality shots, good opportunities? The team which takes care of these things usually is in a better position to win a game.
Oh, and he's not going to be happy with that call.
What a silly foul right there, but look at his face. His facial expression tells it all.
They've got him right where they want him, Dick.
Hey, dodge one there, Brad. The offense can't get that break going.
These boys have really done their homework. All right, let's check in third member of our team again. Here's Aaron Andrews.
The Tigers have done a really good job so far rebounding at the defensive end. This was a key that Dick brought up earlier. They have seemingly taken note and started the half in front because of this. The coaches want this solid rebounding to continue. If not, the first half effort was a waste. Guys?
Thanks, Aaron. The shooting guard gets the pass. 10 on the shot clock. They work the perimeter. He beats him to the punch defensively.
What a terrific job. Footwork really excellent on a post play.
Boy, assist to turnover ratios are big, and that's a big turnover.
I'll tell you, you're turning the ball over too often. You can't win when you do that.
Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper. He tries the jumper. Busts the J. Looking for a good shot. He's in the clear. Missed the jumper. Pushes it up. Goes up for two. Sweet looking shot.
He is super. He really is.
Looking for a good shot. And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with the blocked shot.
Up and in. Cross court. Great defense. Rims out. Gave it up. For two, the layup. Take a look at this highlight, courtesy of Pontiac. They work it around the perimeter. They go with the entry pass on the post. Turnaround jumper.
I tell you, what a nice turnaround jump shot. Soft as velvet, fading away, impossible to block.
On the outside. For the deuce. And off the mark. Now looking for the pick.
Hey, it's important that the dribbler really turns that corner hard when he's using that ball screen.
The center gets the pass. On the outside. Great composure to pass it out of the trap. The center with the ball. Tries for two. Perfectly executed.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. Up and in. On the dribble, gives it up. He looks for the bomb. Poor decision. He has no business taking that shot.
Yeah, that's horrible, Mr. Nestler. Horrible shot selection.
Nice move with a face-up.
I tell you one thing, Brad. I like guys that are versatile in that post. Facing up is a way to take advantage of three basic moves.
Defensively trying to stay with his man, and he's going to pick up a foul.
What a poor job defensively. Very slow inside, and they attack him aggressively.
Eludes the trap there. Works the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Goes up for two. The layup. Here comes the ball screen. The power forward receives the pass. They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, they're really doing a great job packing it in. Did a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
He looks for the bomb. The shot's off target. Up and in.
Little showtime. It's going to be a three-point play. Got the foul. The bench loves it.
Step to the line for the free throw. Makes it. They're making good use of their free throw opportunities tonight.
Good free throw shooting teams seem to always give themselves a chance to win. Great composure to pass it despite the trap, Brad.
The power forward with the ball. Dumps it in. Turnaround jumper. He gets the rebound.
Look at that spacing.
For the bucket. Up and in. Perimeter. And now a with a power move on the inside.
Did a great job protecting the basketball, seals the defense off, and explodes to the basket.
Gave it up. From the top of the circle. Off the mark. The shooting guard with the ball. Moving it around the perimeter. They go with the entry pass on the post. Turnaround jumper. They take it off the defensive glass.
As soon as you get that defensive rebound, you should be looking to push the ball.
They'll work it around the arc. From downtown, he gets the bucket to fall. He passes it out of the trap. Intercepted. Now they work it around the perimeter. He can't get any more open than that. Poor decision there to shoot that three.
Brad, I can guarantee you that he's not the guy they want shooting the ball.
The Tigers have become regulars at the NCAA tournament, Dick.
Strong showings in the postseason doesn't hurt. Up and inside!
He takes the wide open shot. He doesn't get the hook.
I tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on the box.
He shoots from the top of the key. Gets the fade to fall. The Tigers prefer a more balanced attack. They play up-tempo at times, and then really settling in the half court at other times.
They try to really get balanced, and then they'll get some points with tempo by creating a little fast pace, and then slow it down and executing their half-court set, getting high-percentage shots.
Let's check in with Erin Andrews and what she's got in store for us. Erin?
Brad and Dick, what a turn of events down here on the sidelines. The coaches and the players, they are feeling the heat, the message from the bench, defensive stops, and do it now.
All right, thanks, Erin. For the bucket, the lane.
Their defense is absolutely horrible.
They are not putting up much of a fight. Number five handles the feed.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Nice move with a face-up.
I tell you one thing, Brad, I like guys that are versatile in that post. Facing up is a way to take advantage of three basic moves.
Looking to move it around the perimeter. Goes up, knocks it down. For two, up and in. There's such a variety of team styles these days, Dick. What are some of the qualities for a half-court team?
This style really calls for heady players who typically play fundamentally sound, team-oriented basketball. All play styles play team basketball. However, half-court teams will rely more on their teammates to score and defend.
Had a momentary look from three-point land. And there's a lazy pass. It's stolen away. Turnover. Will it turn into two the other way?
Hey, Brad, he finishes this one off the transition.
The shooting guard receives the ball. Working it around the perimeter. With the J, the bucket counts and one.
Hey, great composure to take the foul and still get the shot off.
Potential for a three-point play. Up and in. No problem so far at the free throw line tonight, Dick.
Well, they're making the most of the free ones.
Pushes it up. They might have him in some trouble here, Dick.
Look at that trap, Brad.
Eludes the trap there. Pushes it up. That spin move's not going to work against this defense.
That's a no-no, baby. Defensive player beats him to the spot.
He tries a jump hook.
I tell you, great shot. I don't understand why it's not utilized more often. It's so impossible to block that shot.
Number 21 receives the pass. On the dribble, gives it up. He lets it go. The Tigers have a hot hand right now that's scoring for them at the moment.
Gaddy's on fire.
The point guard receives the pass.
Dump it inside.
You can't be that aggressive. Two shots. Hits the first shot. He sinks them both. Traps in place, Dick. He passes it out of the trap. They work the perimeter. Spin move not successful, Dick.
I did a great job on the defense, not allowing him to make that turn.
He'll go to the line. Count it. They're shooting extremely well from the stripe tonight, Dick.
Yeah, they're making their coaches look good for making them shoot extra free throws every day.
Second shot. They're nailing the free ones tonight, Mr. Vitale.
Hey, this is where you win and lose games, Brad.
Eludes the trap there.
Escape the trap.
Pushes it up. It rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
Number two gets the pass. Gave it up.
Thank you.
He tries to knock down the three. You betcha. Fans will be celebrating tonight, Dick. This one's out of reach.
Well, it's simple. He came out, executed a game plan, and ended up on top.
On the dribble, gives it up. Can their defense get them back in the game, Dick?
I tell you, it's going to be a long hike back, Brad.
Gave it up. He gets the rejection. Gives it up. Tries for two. Was that beautiful or what? Goes up for two. Foul call. Number one steps out onto the court.
Hey, that can't go too long without his presence. Like me, I can't go long without you.
With the free throw. First shot is good. Dick, they're really getting it done from the line tonight, aren't they?
And a surprisingly collective effort, Brad.
Number five is put back in the game.
Hey, this team easily comes apart without him out there, Brad.
Gave it up. They've got him right where they want him, Richard. He passes it out of the trap. Goes up for two with a layup. And there's sort of a snapshot of our game tempo.
We've seen a combination of both short and long possessions here, Brad. Nothing wrong with that if that's your team's ideal style of play. Great pass out of the trap, Brad.
For the bucket. Up and in. Pushes it. Or he blocks the shot. Up for the lay-in. This start the bus moment, courtesy of our good friends at State Farm. Isolated on the outside, they're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper. With the catch. Nice execution on the spin.
I tell you, great spin move to the basket.
Way out on top, controlling the ball. Tries for two. They still don't score. Number 15 takes the pass. He takes the open jumper. He shows the sweet touch from three-point land. Looking for a good shot. For the bucket. Off the rim and no good. Game, we emphasize the points, and likewise at the half. Dick, now your final thoughts.
Every game, there's a plan, Brad. If you execute the game plan, you usually win. Occasionally, you'll play a better team, and they'll just beat you because they're more skilled. However, with a solid game plan and the ability to play your team style, anything can happen.
Thanks, Richard. It's all about playing your team style, and time again, that's what it comes down to. Dick, I think the better team won, we can say that, and it's heartbreak for the other club, but you know, you got to win it and keep on going to get to that final Monday night in April.
Well, I'll tell you, they won this game, Brad, when you look at it and analyze it, because they really had all the right people shoot the ball at the right moment. They did a terrific job offensively.
The Tigers came, they saw, and they conquered their first-round foe, Dick.
I tell you, Brad, watch out for this team, because the coach has these kids playing with more intensity than they ever did during a regular season. And I'm going to tell you, it's going to serve them well, as now they shift into gear for that second-round matchup.
So for Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nessler saying so long.